I mixed up some nice thick mud. Hey, are you helping us, man? Wow.
So in this video, we're going to be testing 9 different products to coat EVA foam and try to seal it as well as we can against staining from oils, wine, and mud and dirt. If you like any of these products, I'm going to leave links down below. They're Amazon affiliate and eBay affiliate links. We do get a small commission from those sales if you use the links in our description. The price for you does not change. I hope you're able to find a good deal on Amazon or eBay through our links. If not, you find a better deal somewhere else. By all means, shop around for the best prices. And let's get started.
And so you guys are aware, I do not get sponsored by any manufacturers of any of the products on any of my videos. This is purely for my enjoyment and to share my experiences with you guys. All of the results that you see are completely unbiased and just based on what I'm seeing. If your results are different, please leave them in the comments below. I'm always curious to see what sort of things other folks are running into with different products and if you've had success with other things that I may have not come across. Today we're going to be testing all of these different products that are different types of nano protectant sprays and traditional protectant sprays that have been around for a while, waterproofers, and what we're going to test it on is EVA foam, which most people know as Seadek, Aquamarine Deck, Marinemat, Gatorstep, and the different products that are essentially all made from EVA foam in different thicknesses and colors, and they use pressure sensitive adhesive on the back, generally 3M pressure sensitive adhesive. And one big problem with them is the way that they stain. They're very resistant to staining and water penetration, but when they do stain with sometimes grease or dirt from feet, they're kind of difficult to get clean. And some people have good luck with it, some people don't. And on our last boat, I had some staining that we couldn't get out. So on this boat, I am doing some testing with all these different products to see if any of them work to help provide additional protection on the EVA foam flooring we have on our boat. And I think other people will find it useful as well. Most of the products that we're using here are UV rated. I think all of them are actually UV rated to work well in the sun and outdoors. And some of them are fabric protectants, some of them are leather protectants, aerospace protectant, canvas waterproofing, fabric guard, water and sun shield for outdoor fabrics, etc. I'll go through them one by one as we go through the testing process to show you what each one does and what the properties are that are advertised. I've got this large section of plywood underneath and EVA foam glued down on top. We're going to label each of these sections and then spray each individual section isolated with this fancy piece of cardboard around each section as we spray, so the spray doesn't get around to the other spots. You can see I've started to label some of them. That one's going to stay with no coating to see how it differentiates from the ones that do have coating. That one is Starbrite Waterproofer. That one is 303 Fabric Guard, and I'll label the rest of these as we go. And we'll test them all out one by one. The first one we're going to be spraying on is Starbrite Waterproofing. Most people use this on outdoor furniture, boat canvas, convertible tops, things like that. It says it waterproofs canvas, nylon, acrylic, and leather. I already sprayed this section with the Starbrite Waterproofing spray, so we're good with this one. Next section we're going to spray is the 303 Fabric Guard. This is the 303 Fabric Guard for marine fabrics, as you can see. Repels moisture and stains, manufacturer recommended, safe for all fabrics. Most people use this on marine vinyl, fabric tops for bimini tops, boat covers, things like that. You can also buy it in gallon size. We've already got this one sprayed as well. We're gonna move on to the next one. These two I had already sprayed before I started the video.
Originally, I was going to test the 303 and the Starbrite.
Now, there's not any sort of product on the shelves that is marketed directly for EVA foam, or any kind of foam for that matter, for stain resistance, water resistance, anything like that. So what I've done is gone through, researched, and found 9 different coatings that seem like they might work based on the properties of each of them, the types of fabrics and materials that they're meant for, and those are the ones we're going to test today.
Next one we're going to be looking at is Scotchgard Water and Sun Shield. It says it's the ultimate water repellency and protection from UV fading. It says protect other nearby surfaces from overspray if overspray occurs. Quickly wipe up, shake can well, apply only to a clean, dry surface, test for color fastness, spray on inconspicuous area, spray with a slow sweeping motion 6 to 8 inches away from article, cover the article uniformly, please do not saturate. Allow article to dry completely before using, reapply seasonally or as needed, and after cleaning. It doesn't tell you what the cure time is, but we're gonna let all of these cure for 48 hours.
So with all of these coatings, there's a lot of different materials and chemicals inside them. So every one, I don't like to shake them because it introduces a lot of air bubbles, depending on how the sprayer is set up. So I just move them back and forth, make sure that you're giving it enough time to mix anything that's inside it that may have separated while it's been sitting on the shelf or being shipped to you. And also, if you notice, I've got a piece of cardboard cut out to sit on top of each of these sections. That way I'm not spraying into the other areas and contaminating the other ones with anything I'm spraying. And before I spray directly into there, just to get everything in here out, I'm just going to spray to make sure everything's out of there. And then we're going to go ahead and coat this. So we've got a nice coat in there. There's a little bit of vapor still in the air inside the box. I'm going to let that settle, remove the box, and then move on to the next one. All right, that one's all done. As you can see, we've got a nice outline around it. You can see the spray marks that went onto the tape, but didn't go onto any of the other sections of EVA. So we've got good isolation for each of these for testing. Next one we're going to be testing is Nikwax TX-Direct. Nikwax makes a lot of different products for different surfaces. The TX-Direct says it adds water repellency and revives breathability. Spray on waterproofing for wet weather clothing with wicking and absorbing liners. For application, hold bottle 15 inches away from garment. Spray evenly to outside of fabric. Wait 2 minutes. Remove any surplus product with a damp cloth. Check carefully to ensure no areas have been missed. Drying. Air dry after several minutes. Check for and remove surplus product with a damp cloth or tumble dry on a low setting. So for this one, these aren't clothes, obviously. So I'm going to spray it on. I'm not going to remove any excess product. I'm going to leave it on there. I'm not really concerned with the way it looks. If there is any sort of chunks or air bubbles left, we just want to see how well it protects. And we're not going to put it in a dryer, obviously, because they're not clothes. It's EVA foam. So we're going to spray it on and we're going to let it cure, and then we'll test it just like the others. We're going to give the bottle a couple of sprays, make sure it's spraying correctly. We've got our box in place, make sure all the spray is isolated, and we'll go ahead and apply it evenly. And if you can see, we've got a nice line around the edge, no contamination with the other spots, and we'll move on to the next one. The next one's going to be the 303 Aerospace. So this one's going to be the 303 Aerospace Protectant. Prevents fading and cracking, repels dust, dirt, and staining, non-greasy. Use only on clean, dry surfaces. For best results, use 303 multi-surface cleaner. Place a drop cloth under the item to be treated to catch any overspray. Out of direct sun, spray product on surface and wipe completely dry with a clean dry towel. Product can also be sprayed on microfiber towel and applicator, then applied to the surface. Apply every 3 to 5 weeks for maximum UV protection. Safe and effective on a variety of surfaces such as vinyl, plastic,
polyethylene, synthetic, and natural rubber PVC.
All right, we're gonna give the bottle a couple of pumps, get it spraying correctly. We've got our box in place. And we'll let that sit as well.
Next one on the list is Bays Fabric Protectant, high performance indoor and outdoor use. Extreme protection, safe water-based formula, eco-responsible, protects against water and oil-based stains, harmful UV rays, contains no acetone or petroleum distillates. Then shake well, spray liberally on clean, dried surface, make sure entire surface has been wet from product, allow to thoroughly dry for a minimum of 24 to 48 hours, depending on temperature.
We'll give it a few pumps. We've got our box ready. And we'll move on to the next one.
The next one is Trinova Aeronautical Protectant. Premium protective shield, provides supreme UV protection, prevents cracking, fading, and aging, safe on all marine surfaces. Spray onto a clean, dry surface and wipe completely dry. If streaking occurs, wipe excess product with a clean, wet towel, following with a dry towel to finish. For best results, reapply every 3 to 5 weeks. So this one, like the Aerospace Protectant from 303, also asks us to reapply every 3 to 5 weeks. I don't want to do that, so I'm going to be pretty hard on these products during this test to see which one truly holds up the best.
We're going to give it a few pumps. All right. We'll get started. We've got our box in place.
And we'll move on to the next one. The next product's gonna be Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock. Resists spills and stains, long-lasting formula, safe for use on all coated leather. And from what I've read, it's also safe for use on vinyl and other leather and vinyl-like products. So I'm hoping that this one does well on EVA foam. We'll see.
I have to admit, Dr. Beasley's does a really good job of their packaging in a box, not just thrown in an Amazon box. And they have a very well thought out website. Whether this product works well or not, I have to give it to them. They do really well with packaging and being very informative on their website, so you know exactly what you're buying.
All right, here's the bottle. Comes with the spray head, which I'll put on in a second. Again, this is the Leather Lock product from Dr. Beasley's. Leather Lock is a polymer coating designed to protect all top-coated leather surfaces. It enhances the leather's ability to resist oil, alcohol, soil, and water. This means you don't have to worry about spills, stains, and dye transfer. This chemically bonding formula lasts at least a year and will significantly increase the lifespan of your fine leather surfaces. The instructions are literally only these three squares. Apply to surface, let sit, wipe clean. Doesn't really tell us how long, but we're gonna let all of this stuff sit for 48 hours before we do any sort of testing.
We'll give the bottle a couple of squirts. And we've got our box in place. We'll get it coated. And move on to the next one.
So this next one is Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. I'm assuming the ingredients are similar to the Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock that we did just before this, but I'm not completely sure. This one is a wipe-on, not a spray-on, so the application is going to be a little bit different. It comes with the Leather Lock Pro leather coating prep and foam applicator. And as far as packaging goes, they do not disappoint. This one is packaged just as well. Your detailing prescription. Comes with the kit information. This is what's in the kit, the prep, and then the Leather Lock Pro. Pretty impressive for packaging. I'm assuming this works well on vehicles I'll test this against a couple other leather protectants on some leather as well on a follow-up video here in a week or so. The instructions: shake leather coating prep, spray it on the surface, wipe it off, repeat until the leather surfaces are prepped. This will allow Leather Lock Pro to perfectly adhere to the surface. So I'm assuming the first application with the coating prep is some sort of a primer based on the instructions. Step 2, shake Leather Lock Pro and prime the foam applicator by applying 8 to 10 drops. Step 3, move the foam applicator over the surface and use the edge of the applicator to ensure all stitching is treated. Allow for surface to cure for 20 to 30 minutes. Wipe off with a fresh towel. Again, I'm not going to be wiping any of these off. I don't care what the residue looks on top, like on top. This is on foam. It's not on leather. It's not on paint. It's not any sort of smooth plastic surface. So all we're concerned about, for the most part, is how well these products protect. So I'm not wiping any of them off. Step 5, repeat steps 3 and 4 until all surfaces are treated. Add 3 to 4 more drops when moving to a new panel. After Leather Lock Pro is applied, liquids and dirt will be repelled from the leather surface. Wipe up will be an easy process. And if you've ever done any sort of ceramic coating on your vehicle or your boat, you'll probably recognize that the process and the applicator foam block is very similar to the ceramic coating process. You put some drops on this on your applicator, you wipe it on in a crisscross pattern, one time this way, one time this way, and then you buff it off, essentially. If you were doing this on leather. So that's interesting. I wonder if it's based on some type of ceramic coating. We're gonna start with the leather coating prep as the instructions. I'm gonna give it a few pumps. There we go. And I'm gonna aim it this way so we're not getting into any of those top sections. And then get my clean microfiber cloth. Got it folded up. I'm going to use the other side. Whatever this first step is, there's probably no alcohol in it because it's not wiping off my permanent marker. Usually anything with alcohol will typically start wiping off whatever you have written in permanent marker. It's taking something off. You can see that. I don't know if it's dirt or some of the gray color on the foam. So we'll let it sit for about 5 minutes and then we'll start applying the Leather Lock Pro itself. All right, our surface is dry to the touch and we're ready to go. I've got the foam applicator that came with the Leather Lock Pro kit. You want to use the soft side, not the hard side. So make sure you don't get the wrong end of it. And we've got our Leather Lock Pro coating. So the instructions said for priming the applicator, we're going to use about 8 drops. So we'll count 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that's more than 8. That's probably 10. We'll let that sit for a second and soak into the applicator and we'll get started. So we're going to go in a cross pattern, first this way and then the other direction. So as you can tell, I've got the majority of my stuff right here and less as we go. This surface is very absorbent and it's absorbing a lot of this stuff. So it's gonna have to be applied differently than it would on an actual leather surface. This may not work. For this one, but for EVA foam, this is probably not the right product, and I don't think it'll really do much for us. We'd have to use a ton of it to get it to really do anything. It's just absorbing into the surface a lot.
Yeah, that's not really doing a whole lot. I'll go ahead and finish the surface best I can, but I would not recommend using this on EVA foam. I'm sure it works really well on leather and vinyl. I'm going to go ahead and test it on leather and vinyl since I already have it here, and it's a pretty expensive product. So might as well test it. About as evenly as I can get that without getting too crazy. So, not disappointed with the product, but very obvious that for EVA foam, we need something that sprays on. This type of a product, drops, ceramic coat, etc., is just not gonna work. So we've got all of them applied. As you can see, 9 different products, 9 different squares. Again, no coating on that one. Starbrite Waterproofing, 303 Fabric Guard, 303 Aerospace, Nikwax TX-Direct, Scotchgard Water and Sun, Base Fabric Protector, Trinova Aeronautical, Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, and Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. As far as dry time, that 303 Aerospace and the 303 Fabric Guard dried the quickest. Nikwax is still very wet. Scotchgard is wet but has settled and soaked into the foam. Base Fabric Protectant is still wet. You can see the drops. Trinova Aeronautical looks like it has a nice slick surface there. It's mostly soaked into the foam. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock has beat it up a lot. I'm not sure if that's the solvents or water that might be in the product. And the Leather Lock Pro, we had to wipe it in and soaked in very rapidly, as you saw during the application. So we'll check on these in 2 days, and then we'll start doing our testing. So now that everything's cured and ready to go, it's been sitting for 3 days, give or take, and everything should be cured nice and good. Let's take some observations here before we get started with the testing. There's a 303 Fabric Guard, looks the same as the Starbrite Waterproofing, and no coating, no change in color. The Scotchgard Water and Sun Repellent, if you can tell there in the very corner, the part that didn't get coated, the Scotchgard made the material a little bit darker, not by much, but just a little bit. Nikwax did not have any sort of effect on the color. 303 Aerospace made the material just a hint darker. And then if you can tell, it also bled some of the permanent marker there. You can see it in the video. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock did not have any sort of effect on the color, did not bleed any on the writing. Trinova, you can see the outline there, and also on this corner here, where it did make the material darker, and it also did bleed with the permanent marker. The Beasleys Fabric Protectant bled just a little bit with the permanent marker, and if you can see the outline there, and there in the corner, it did make the material just a little bit darker. And then finally, the Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro did bleed the color a little bit and did not change the color of the material. The bleeding, I think, is probably due to some of the solvents that are in some of these applications, and the solvents like alcohol or acetone or any other sort of thinner that might be in these is probably what's causing the bleeding. So if you have any material that you're applying these to that has some sort of a printed logo or something else on there that might bleed, if you have acetone or alcohol or something along those on there, those lines on there, then be careful when you're applying these. Otherwise, it doesn't look like, other than darkening up the foam in a couple of instances, like the Scotchgard, the Trinova, the Bays, the 303 Aerospace, a few of them that darkened up the material. Otherwise, the effect on the color, the existing color, doesn't seem to be too noticeable. Now let's get started with the testing. The first thing I want to test is just water and how well all of these different ones
help protect against water soaking into the material. And then we're going to use our section with no coating as a comparison point to see how that compares to the other ones that do have coating. I've got a syringe full of water. We're going to start with the section that has no coating and see how it reacts. We've got pretty good beading there. I'm going to push it in a little bit. See if it soaks in any. We'll let it sit for just a second, see if any of it soaks in. It didn't soak in. We're gonna leave it and see if it changes by sitting for a few minutes. Next, we're gonna move on to the Starbrite waterproofing. It beads up just like it did on the section with no coating. I'm gonna try to rub it in here. Oh wow. So you can see when I try to rub it in, the water stays beaded up. Whereas the section with no coating, when I rubbed it in, the water is not totally absorbing into the material, but it doesn't bead up. It's flattening out and it's absorbing just a little bit into the top layer of the foam. Here, it just stays beaded up. Doesn't puddle or pool at all into the material. That's interesting. Okay, we'll leave that for a second. And we're gonna move on to the 303 fabric guard. Okay, now we're on to the 303 fabric guard. Let's give this one a shot with water. This one is super, super hydrophobic, much more so than the Starbrite waterproofer. Look at that. That's very interesting. So, also better than no coating and much more hydrophobic than the Starbrite. That's very interesting. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Now with the Starbrite waterproofing, even after it's sat for several minutes, the water's still not soaking in at all. With no coating, some of the water has soaked in, some of it has still sat in a water droplet on top of the material. With 303 Fabric Guard, the water is all still sitting right on top of the foam, on top of the 303 Fabric Guard coating on top of the foam. None of it has soaked in. Let's move on to the 303 Aerospace. It's a little bit windy, so the water might move around. Okay, so the 303 Aerospace is performing horribly. The water is soaking right in, and whatever the solvents are in this 303 Aerospace seem like they may have broken down the surface of the EVA foam and caused it to be even more absorbent than it was without any coating at all. If you can see, it's all just soaking right in. None of it's beading. None of it is wanting to stay on top of the foam. It's actually all just soaking in. Let's move on to Nikwax TX-Direct. We have good beading. Very good beading action. Let's see how hydrophobic this stuff is. So, I'm not sure how good you can see it on camera, but if I had to compare against the Nikwax, Starbrite Waterproofing, and the 303 Fabric Guard, Nikwax TX-Direct is definitely in third place. Starbrite Waterproofing would be in second place, and the 303 Fabric Guard so far would definitely be in first place as far as its hydrophobic properties go. The water just doesn't bead as well on this Nikwax. All right, let's move on to the next one.
The next one here is the Scotchgard Water and Sun. Very hydrophobic. Try to catch this water before it moves into our next test section. But as you can see there for a second, the water is super duper hydrophobic on this one. And if you remember, this is one of the ones that did change the color a little bit. That's with the coating, that's without. So this is about as hydrophobic as the 303 Fabric Guard, as far as how water is reacting to the coating. Nothing soaking in. All of it's sitting directly on top of the coating. Doesn't seem like anything is getting to where it's soaking into the foam. It's a little bit more slippery of a coating than the 303. But as far as how the water's reacting, it's about the same as the 303 Fabric Guard. All right, let's move on to the next one.
Next is Bay's Fabric Protectant. And if you remember, this one also changed the color just slightly. That's with the protectant, that's without. The permanent marker did bleed a little bit once the coating was applied. Let's go ahead and get some water on here.
So this one is also very hydrophobic. I'm not sure how well you can tell on video, but this one is actually more hydrophobic than the 303 Fabric Guard and the Scotchgard Water and Sun. It's interesting though, the water is wanting to pool instead of bead. If you can see that, the water is starting to pool here. Let's give it another few seconds and see what it does. You know, as I'm rubbing the water in, just like I did on the other samples, it seems like it's wanting to soak past the coating and into the foam, even though it seemed like it was more hydrophobic at first when the water hit the surface. So that's interesting. The water is adhering more to the foam itself and getting past the coating. All right, let's move on to the next one.
Next, we have Trinova Aeronautical.
So as you can notice, the water is not beading and it's actually soaking in more than the foam that had no coating. So whatever the solvent is that they use in this coating, my guess would be that it has eaten away a little bit of the water repelling nature of the foam itself. So this one is about on the same level as the 303 Aerospace so far. They both, for some reason, caused the foam to lose a little bit of the water repelling nature that it had on its own. It's interesting. So as I was just padding up the water to make sure that we've got a clean surface on for our next test, it even bled off some of the marker on here. So whatever that solvent is definitely making the surface properties different than normal EVA foam and not as protective. This stuff may work well on fabrics or leather or something else. Now we're on to Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock. I've got high hopes for this one based on a couple of things. One, it didn't change the color of the EVA foam to me, meaning that the solvents in the spray were not strong enough to change the surface in any sort of way. and hopefully have added some additional protection compared to just bare EVA foam. Here we go. I'm not sure how well you saw that on video. This one is super hydrophobic. Let's try to rub some of this water around and see if it soaks in like some of the other ones did. So far, it's not soaking in, so that's a good sign. Everything is staying on top of the coating. I'm not sure how well you can see that in the video. You don't see any dark marks where it's soaking in. I went ahead and wiped off the water just to see what the surface looks like, and a little bit of it did soak in. So far, I think the winner is probably Scotchgard Water and Sun and 303 Fabric Guard, and this one would probably come in third place. All right, let's move on to the next one. The last one we're testing here is Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. I'm not sure what the actual material difference is between Leather Lock Pro and Leather Lock. Leather Lock is a spray-on, and this one is a wipe-on like ceramic coating would be with an applicator and a dropper. And it didn't really apply well, to be perfectly honest. It was too absorbent, and it didn't give us a good way to actually apply it to the EVA foam. It kept going on in streaks. On actual leather or vinyl, it would probably do a lot better. But just for kicks, let's see how it did. So, as you can see, it's pretty hydrophobic, more so than the Leather Lock. My assumption would be is whatever, whether they're using silica or something else, whatever the active ingredient is in the Leather Lock, Leather Lock Pro probably has more of it, but I don't know. But this one is super, super hydrophobic. If I could convince Dr. Beasley's to give me something in between these two, in a spray form instead of a dropper, I bet that would be the ticket. When we try to rub some of the water droplets in. So it's not absorbing, but the water is creating a little bit of a film right there. Let's wipe it off and see what's remaining. None of the water really absorbed, but it is in the grooves of the EVA foam. That's interesting. And so you guys are aware, I do not get sponsored by any manufacturers of any of the products on any of my videos. This is purely for my enjoyment and to share my experiences with you guys. All of the results that you see are completely unbiased and just based on what I'm seeing. If your results are different, please leave them in the comments below. I'm always curious to see what sort of things other folks are running into with different products, and if you've had success with other things that I may have not come across. I mixed up some nice thick mud, just watery enough to where we can handle it, but very thick, probably much thicker than you would end up with on your boat when it comes to dirt and mud from shoe prints, things like that, and we'll test with this. For the mud, I'm going to apply it to all 9 products and also the section with no coating, and I'll go through each of them one by one after I've applied it. Hopefully it doesn't slide around as easily as the water did so that we can look at what each one does. We've got our mud and the syringe, and here we go. That is the section with no coating. We're gonna rub it in. See how that does. It did soak in. Here's the section with Starbrite Waterproofing.
can't really tell if it did soak in or if it's just in the grooves. We'll give it a minute to sit and come back and check it.
Here's the 303 fabric guard. Wow.
Let's rub it in. Let's go on to the next one.
Here's a 303 Aerospace. Just like the water, it's soaking in pretty much right away, even more than the EVA surface without coating. Here's the Nikwax TX-Direct. Wow. That one is just not soaking any of the mud water in. Interesting. Here's the Scotchgard Water and Sun. So far, that's got to be the best one. Next one is Beasleys Fabric Protectant. Next one is the Trinova Aeronautical. Next one is Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock. Not too bad. And the last one is Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. I'm gonna give all of these a few minutes to sit and maybe even dry. I want the actual water to dry out to where all we have left is just dirt. This is after about 5 minutes. Let's see how each of them look. No coating. There's dirt on the surface. It's spread into the grooves. Starbrite. The dirt's not soaked in as much as with no coating, but it is in the grooves there. 303 fabric guard. It seems like the liquid is still sitting on top of whatever the coating is, but it is kind of soaked into those grooves. 303 Aerospace, it's pretty much soaked into the EVA. Nikwax TX Direct, very good stain repellency there. It doesn't look like any of the dirt has actually soaked into the foam. doing pretty well. Scotchgard, by far our winner so far. Scotchgard Water and Sun, that particular one. I'll leave links to all of these in the description below so you know exactly which products I use, because all of these manufacturers have different lines that act differently, have different sorts of additives, different chemicals in them, etc. But look at that. That one is interesting. Whatever the barrier is that the Scotchgard has created, it's even keeping the mud from getting into the grooves, the actual lines in the EVA foam. Next, we've got Bay's Fabric Protectant. It's doing well. I can't say that it's really soaked in. It's definitely evenly spread on the foam, but it doesn't look like it's soaking in really yet. Trinova Aeronautical, not doing well. It's soaked into the EVA. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, doing pretty well. It doesn't look like anything has soaked in. It's definitely just sitting on top, but we'll see how it does once we get around to cleaning it. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro, all the fluids are just slowly dripping off. Even though this is a fairly flat surface we're on, I guess it's angled a little bit this way. We'll give these another 20 minutes or so, maybe 30 minutes, come back and check on them. Here's a 30 minute update. These have been sitting for a little while. Let's go through them. So, no coating. The water's dried up. Some of it soaked in, most of it evaporated, and the mud is still there. Starbrite Waterproofing. All the water's gone. I don't know if it evaporated or not. It doesn't look like much of it soaked in, and the mud's still there, the dirt. 303 Fabric Guard, the water's gone, no water spotting, and the dirt's still there. 303 Aerospace, the water is soaked in pretty good into the foam. It's still wet, and the dirt is there as well. Nikwax TX-Direct, a little bit of the water is still there, very little. I don't know if it's just in the grooves or if it's soaked in. We'll give it more time, and the dirt is definitely still there. Scotchgard Water and Sun, and the mud and muddy water is sort of beaded up into a bunch of little spots. It's starting to dry more and more, evaporation, but so far that one's looking really good. Bay's Fabric Protectant, the water is gone. It looks like it soaked in a little bit along with the mud, and the dirt is remaining. We'll see how well that comes off. Trinova Aeronautical, it's soaked in pretty good, and the dirt's still there. The water is kind of damp still on the foam. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, the water is all gone. The remaining dirt is not much, but it is there and it's dry. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, this part here, the water is still sitting on top of the foam. It hasn't dried up yet. So this was a 30 minute update. We will come back in another half hour.
Hey, are you helping us, man? You want to come help? Yep.
All right, guys, we're 3 hours in past the mud. Everything is dry. That's no coating. Starbrite Waterproofing Spray, 303 Fabric Guard, 303 Aerospace, Nikwax TX Direct, Scotchgard Water and Sun, Bay's Fabric Protectant, Trinova Aeronautical, Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, and Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro.
And I am going to rinse this stuff off just with water, no soap, no nothing. Let's see how well the mud stains come off. And also, let's see how hydrophobic the surfaces still are. We've got our water hose on. Let's start at the bottom.
So we've got Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. Stain is still there, might need scrubbing. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock. A little bit of it came off, but the stain is still there. Trinova Aeronautical.
Wow,
stain is totally gone. Bay's Fabric Protectant. Thank you. stain is still there. Gonna need more scrubbing. 303 Aerospace. You know, even though the 303 Aerospace made the EVA foam lose its hydrophobic properties, it did protect it. That stain came right off. Better than the Trinova. Trinova came off, but this one just came right off with no effort at all. All right, next one. Nikwax TX-Direct. Stain didn't come off. Gonna need more scrubbing. Scotchgard Water and Sun. Came off a little, but it's still there. Need more scrubbing. Next one is 303 Fabric Guard. Mostly off, a little bit still on there. The 303 Aerospace and the Trinova Aeronautical did the best so far. 303 Aerospace, I would say, is number one on the stain resistance. Trinova Aeronautical, then 303 Fabric Card would probably come in third. Next one is Starbrite Waterproofing. I'd say about 30% of it came off. The rest is still there, needs scrubbing. And finally, no coating at all, just straight EVA foam. That also came off maybe 30-40%, but still needs more scrubbing to come off. Coating, not hydrophobic at all. At this point, all the scrubbing we did, it looks like anything that was on there that was creating some hydrophobic surface is gone, and the stain is there. As far as how hydrophobic these stayed, Starbrite Waterproofer, you can tell where we rubbed the mud in. Not hydrophobic, the rest of it's beading. 303 Fabric Card, same thing. Where we rubbed the mud in, not very hydrophobic. We probably rubbed some of the coating off, I bet. Or changed its properties, but the rest of it's hydrophobic. 303 Fabric Guard, or I'm sorry, 303 Aerospace, not hydrophobic, all the water soaked in, but very good on the stain resistance. Nikwax, hydrophobic in all the different areas, a little bit less where we rub the mud in, but still has hydrophobic properties and the water's beading. Scotchgard Water and Sun, hydrophobic everywhere, including where we rub the mud in. On this one, I bet if we wipe it down, it's gonna take all that mud off and we'll still have our hydrophobic properties. Bays, stain's still there, no hydrophobic properties. Trinova, stain is gone. It is still hydrophobic. Dr. Beasley's and Leather Lock, neither one stayed hydrophobic. Now we're gonna test with oil, motor oil. Specifically Pennzoil 10W30, non-synthetic, just standard dyno oil. We're gonna rub a little bit into each section. As you can tell, I have not used any sort of soap or cleaner to get the dirt stains off. We're gonna leave them there until we're done with the oil stain test. And then lastly, we'll go back and use some regular car wash soap to see what will and what won't come out. So let's get started. I've got a little bit of oil dripped onto each section. It's only been about 30 seconds. Let's see how each one's doing. This is with no coating. As you can see, it is starting to soak in a little bit. This is with the Starbrite Waterproofing. And as you can see, it's not soaking in. It's sitting on top of the coating, almost in a little bubble. That one is the 303 Fabric Guard. It has not soaked in at all either. It's just sitting there right on top of the foam. This one is the Scotchgard Water and Sun. It's almost all the way soaked in. So that one's soaking into the actual foam. This one's the Nikwax TX Direct It hasn't soaked in as quickly as a Scotchgard, but it is soaking in. That one's the 303 Aerospace, almost completely soaked into the foam. This one is Bay's Fabric Protectant, and the oil is just sitting on top of the coating, has not soaked in at all. This one's the Trinova Aeronautical, it's almost completely soaked in. This one is Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock. It's starting to soak in just a little bit, but for the most part, it's sitting on top of the coating. And this one is Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. That one's Leather Lock. This one's Leather Lock Pro. And just like the water, it's soaking in a little bit, but it's also creating a little bit more of a slippery surface, and it's dripping down to the bottom. So I'm gonna leave these on here for a little bit of time, and we'll come back and check on it. So here's a 30-minute update. Let's see how everything looks. With no coating, it is completely soaked in. Starbrite Waterproofing. The oil is still sitting on top. Although it looks like that little tail on the end of it may have soaked in a little bit, I'm not sure. Hard to tell at this point. 303 Fabric Guard, it is sitting there in a perfect little puddle, hasn't soaked in at all. 303 Aerospace, it has soaked in a little bit differently, and I don't see the color from the oil, which over here, I do see the color from the oil, so that's interesting. Nikwax TX-Direct, completely soaked in. Scotchgard Water and Sun, the oil is soaked in. Again, less color, but the oil is soaked in. Bay's Fabric Protectant, it is sitting there right on top of the coating, has not soaked in. Trinova Aeronautical has soaked in, very shiny. I'm not sure why it's different looking, or if you can see it on the video, but it's got a very glossy, shiny, wet look to it. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, it has not soaked in. It slid down a little bit, hasn't sat in a nice little ball like the 303 Fabric Protectant, so probably a little bit less hydrophobic on this coating, but it still hasn't soaked into the foam. And Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro, it did soak in where it was sliding down and it slid off.
So now you'll notice the oil stains are dried. I have not washed any of them off or any of the dirt. I'm gonna leave them there. And next, we're gonna put some red wine. Have it in a cup here. We're gonna put some red wine on the EVA foam. Not on top of the oil, just over to the side of the oil stains. Rub it in and see how the coatings hold up. Then after the wine has had time to dry, we're going to go back and observe what all of them look like. And then finally, give everything a good wash. And afterwards, we're going to give everything a good wash and see what comes off, what doesn't, what creates permanent staining, and which coatings hold up the best.
And little Archie's gonna help us.
First, we're gonna test the one with no coating. Next, the Starbrite Waterproofing. Not really soaking in, it's just sitting on top of the coating. Next is 303 Fabric Guard. That's interesting, the way it reacts. Kind of shrinks itself back up into a little puddle. Next is 303 Aerospace. Next is the Nikwax TX-Direct. Next is Scotchgard Water and Sun. Next is Bay's Fabric Protectant. You can see the little beads just sitting on top. That's interesting. Next one is Trinova Aeronautical. Next is Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock. And finally, we have Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. We're going to let all of these sit, come back in 30 minutes, check on them. What do you think, Archie? Nope. Dreaming about the results? Good boy. One other thing to note, I was also going to test with cooking oil in addition to the motor oil, but since we got such good penetration with the motor oil in all of these samples, I'm going to skip the testing with the cooking oil so that we can get onto the results. Quick update about an hour after application on the wine. No coating is soaked in. Starbrite Waterproofing is dried, and I don't know if it's soaked in or not, but it's definitely dried. 303 Fabric Guard, it's still puddled on there, has not soaked in. 303 Aerospace is soaked in. Nikwax TX-Direct is soaked in. Scotchgard Water and Sun did not soak in, it's just puddled there. Bay's Fabric Protectant is soaked in. Trinova Aeronautical is soaked in. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock is soaked in. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro is also soaked in. So we'll check back again a little while later. At this point, all of the wine stains are dry. This is about maybe 3 hours after. So at this point, I'll let it sit a little bit longer, then we'll go back and wash everything and see what comes off. So right away, let's take a look at what the results look like. Most of the dirt washed off the one with no coating. The wine came off. The oil, absolutely not. It's still all in there. On the Starbrite Waterproofing, it's hard to see on the camera, but the dirt stain, the little center part, is still there. Sorry about the shadows from the trees. It's difficult to see. A little bit of the oil stain is still there, and the wine definitely washed off. 303 Fabric Guard, little bit of the dirt stain right here. That might come out with a little bit more scrubbing. The oil is almost all gone. I can't see any of the oil stain, but we'll check it after it dries, and the wine is definitely gone. 303 Aerospace, we've got a little bit of the wine stain that's still there. Very small
imprint of the oil stain still there and the dirt is gone. Nikwax TX-Direct. I think you can probably see on the video, the dirt stain is there and I can still feel the oil. So the oil residue is there, but the wine is gone. The Scotchgard Water and Sun, the oil seems to be gone. I'll want to take a look at it afterwards. I see a little bit of the wine stain still remaining and the dirt is gone. The Beasleys Fabric Protectant, I see a little bit of the oil stain still there. The wine is gone. I see a little bit of the dirt stain still here. Trinova Aeronautical, most of the stains are gone. I see a little bit of glossy residue from the oil, so something's still there. And nope, that's just the shadow. Yeah, the wine is gone, the dirt's gone, and there's a little bit of oil residue remaining. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, the dirt stains are still kind of there. The wine is gone. The oil, it's hard to tell. The oil seems to be gone, but there's a little bit of a slick surface remaining. So we'll check that one more in detail once it dries. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro. I see the stain. You see the imprint here from the oil drip when it was kind of sliding off the material. So the oil stain is there. The wine stain is mostly gone, but I see a little bit of red remaining there. And the dirt is kind of patchy. Some of it's gone, some of it's not.
We are ready for the final results. So everything's dry now. And we're ready to see how it all turned out. So no coating. You can see there's some residue from the mud that we put on there. The wine is all gone. The oil stain is very apparent. It didn't come out even with the car wash soap. The Starbrite Waterproofing, everything came out pretty good. You can see a little bit of redness from the wine stain, a little bit of dirt remaining. And I'm not sure if you see it in the video or not. A little bit of dirt from the mud. The oil is all gone. 303 Fabric Guard. Everything seems to have come off. I don't see any sort of residue from the mud, the oil, or the dirt. 303 Aerospace. If you can see it in the video, there's an outline of the oil stain still there. There's a little bit of redness from the one. The Nikwax TX Direct. I gotta say, I was pretty excited about this one, but the results aren't that great. The oil stain's there. The mud, you can see it splotched everywhere. It's still there. The wine is gone. The wine stain's gone. Scotchgard Water and Sun. A very light outline of the oil stain is still there. The mud and the wine are completely gone. Bayer Fabric Protectant. Very small outline of the oil stain is still there. The mud and wine came completely off. Trinova Aeronautical. Very, very light outline of the oil stain is still there. And as I noted before, when I was washing it with the car wash soap afterwards, it still felt a little bit slick. And the wine is gone and the dirt is gone from the mud. Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock, real splotchy. The oil's a little bit there. The dirt and the wine are gone. And lastly, we've got the Dr. Beasley's Leather Lock Pro, the foam applicator pad that you wiped on as you put the drops of the sealant on there. It just didn't really apply well to something that was so absorbent like this EVA foam. So overall, let me know what your thoughts are in the comments below. From what I'm seeing here, the 303 Fabric Guard is probably in first place. Starbrite Waterproofing is in second place. I'd say 303 Aerospace is in third place. Scotchgard Water and Sun is tied for third place. And then the rest of them, I just wouldn't use on EVA foam. You gotta remember, these products were not meant for EVA foam. Each of them have their own specific application that they're designed for. There's not a particular coating that's out today for EVA foam protection. So I went ahead and tested the ones with the properties that seemed like they would be the closest fit.
and this is what we've got. I think our test results were great. I'm glad I didn't apply any of these to my boat previous to testing. I hope you find the video helpful. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. I'm always happy to help out.